All right, now we move to page 94 of the magazine. Our next Platinum Senior Vice President, our final promotion of the day. These two individuals, I can tell you, when 5LINX was just a couple years old, we were a year old, we stayed in contact. Jeb Tyler constantly called this individual. He was working with another company. He was making a whole lot of money. He had a huge organization that was all over the United States. And him and Jeb would stay in contact. And Jeb would constantly keep trying to get him to come take a look at 5LINX. He said time wasn't right. He was doing just fine. And I believe this went on for almost 3 years before something finally took place in that other company that he was ready to take a look. So him and his partner came up to Rochester, sat down myself, Craig, and Jeb, and he came to Rochester, I believe, for it was 3 days. I mean, going through a list of questions that he had prepared with his attorney and making sure that we were everything that we said we were going to be, and we were going to be here for the long haul, and we were going to continue to put the representatives first before he stepped his leadership into this company. And for 3 days, we went through this and answered every question and really just felt that we were going to create a lifelong partnership if they decided to join forces with 5LINX. So as they started in 5LINX, they brought their team of leaders up to the company in the following week to tell them everything that they felt this company stood for. And through that, they were promoted to senior vice president. Through senior vice president, they have built the largest organization in 5LINX today. The WGI organization today in 5LINX has over 23,000 business partners and over 100,000 customers that Barry and C get paid on every month. Barry Donalson had his son Blake, who's 3, and Carl's son Corey is their inspiration why they've continued to build their business at this high level. Building out of Chicago and Dallas, and building out of California and Las Vegas, where they reside. Today, they have in WGI, they have 14 senior vice presidents in their organization. And three platinum senior vice presidents. So it's our honor to promote to the position of Platinum Senior Vice President Barry Donalson and Carl Anthony Harris. Congratulations, new Platinum SVP.
Ain't no stopping now. No, we're May the Most High name of Christ bless all of you. And I just want to let you know that I really sincerely love each and every one of you in this arena. And words cannot explain the way I feel about what we started. First, I want to give thanks to the Most High. And I want to thank Craig, Jeb, and Jason for creating this opportunity and for accepting us in March of 2004 when we came up to the Home Office and tolerated our 3 days of interrogation. And I want to thank my partner who included me in this deal to carry on this journey. I always knew I was destined for greatness. And I'm the oldest of three, the only son, the first grandson, the first nephew, the first everything. And I knew that it was my responsibility because my dad always said, we can't afford that. And we grew up with that mentality, that stigma. And I became an adult, always telling myself I can't afford something. That's right. I knew I was going to impact my family's life because I was going to make the Harris name a remarkable name across the world. I'm doing this business for my lovely mother, my two grandmothers, my only son. And I can't say any much more than adding to my family tree. My lovely wife of 2 years, going to be in September 1st. I'll be married for 2 years, so I've been on my honeymoon ever since then, to Donna Maria Thompson. And I want to publicly apologize to Donna for leaving her home many weeks, not talking to her because I'm focused. You see, when I'm focused on something, you can't get me off of it. And I told her that I would definitely make sure that we live a life of luxury and happiness because God intended us to live in abundance. My nephews and my sisters, my lovely two sisters, but more importantly, I always wanted to build a family outside of the Harris family. That's when I got together and put together that awesome team and that vision called WGI, Worldgate Industries. Yes. And Worldgate is the gate to the world. I always wanted to go across the world and impact in humankind and bring out the God-given power to individuals and open up opportunities across the world. I didn't know how. I thought it was the other opportunities, but when I saw 5LINX, I knew that's where WGI will expand across the world. And now, look where it is. This is how we do it. Top class. We don't mess around. Worldgate, don't hesitate. And they're always living on the five wealth principles. The book I wrote, Living the Five Wealth Principles, was built on the foundation of WGI and my growth of being persistent, being consistent with discipline, urgency, and what? Excitement. And that's the foundation we build this organization on. And I'm happy to know that we're able to bring leaders to fall into that vision, like Lisa with the Elite Marketing Organization, my brother for life. Sonny Babla Pinyan would always be my brother for life. I have a lot of brothers in WGI. I mean, Peter Minyang is such a guy that... I mean, you know, when you just pray to God and you just got to stay still and just accept the blessings when it comes, and just walk forward to it because it's going to happen to you. And now I got so many brothers in my organization. It's like, and they're such heart-filled individuals, God-blessed individuals, and the sisters, the WGI, you guys are no joke. I'm looking to build a long-lasting relationship and grow old with you guys, wealthy.
Yes.
And nothing's going to stop us. But before I bring my partner on, this is what I want to let you guys know. Change is uncomfortable. And in order for us to build wealth, we're going to have to change. Personal development is foremost. If you want to get to the other side, you got to be willing to change. Mentally, physically, spiritually, professionally, and financially. And that's the platform that WGI lives on, in changing people's lives, but first starting with you. I've been through a whole lot of changes, and I expect to go through a whole lot more. Because when you're going to create 100 millionaires, it's going to cost us some work and some commitment living the five wealth principles. So with that said, I just want to leave you guys with this. Now it's time for us to take WGI, Worldgate Industries, all over the globe. But what your commitment is this. My mission now for the next 36 months is to build 5LINX internationally. But first, we're going to start right here in the United States. And I'm calling all senior vice presidents in 5LINX, all platinum senior vice presidents in 5LINX, and all national directors to join the quest with me to taking our company to being $1 billion. You guys with me? So with that said, I have a lot of respect for my partner. You know, we fight a lot. But he's a man of integrity. And regardless of what, if we got a fight and that's going to make me change and become a better person and him to change and become a better person so we can impact the world, so be it. Because guess what? I ain't going anywhere. I'm here for life to build and to build together. So guys, put a warm welcome to my business partner, co-founder of WGI, none other than Mr. Barry Donalson.
I love you guys, man. I don't do this promotion thing very often. I'll get to it. people think that I'm hardcore and I am a strong black man, I really am, but I just believe in what I'm doing. And I don't follow too many people. Because when I have, I've been let down. And so I try to live my life where I call my own shots. I'm going to do what I say I'm going to do. I live my life with high integrity. And one thing I want you to know is that I probably wouldn't be here in this company if it wasn't for those three guys over there. Because in this business, in this industry, I've been let down so many times. And when I did come to the home office, I knew that if I decided to do this business, I was going to do the business in a way that it was going to be the last thing I was going to build as a representative. You know, today this is, I said, my last SVP promotion. It was the last position I would build as a distributor. The Platinum Senior Vice President is the last position I would build as a distributor. And I'm glad that I can stand with a company side by side and finish my career as a distributor with a company that I believe in and a company that I know that would do the right thing. I mean, you guys don't really understand the type of integrity the guys have, but especially Mr. Jerabeck. Yes. When we have somebody at the helm like that who understands business, he runs it from a business perspective, and I respect that because that allows us to stay in business when a lot of companies may not stay in business. So through this journey to become a Platinum Senior Vice President, a lot of things have been happening in my life. I went through a divorce. You fight attorneys. I got dealt with pneumonia. And for me, pneumonia is like a death warrant. And most people don't realize that in order for you to do something that you really believe in, you really have to commit levels that you can't even imagine. So I want to tell you that if it seemed like that I'm a hard guy, if it seemed like that I push you hard, I push the organization, it's because I can tell you that if it wasn't for 5LINX and I had built successful businesses, and I'm a pretty good steward of my money, but I tell you, if it wasn't for 5LINX, what I've been going through for the last several months, I would have been in trouble. And so I thank you guys from the top of my heart. Because because when you're writing checks for $15,000 and $20,000 and $25,000 just to try to maintain some sanity in life, it's no joke. So I want to tell you this. Carl, thank you for building with us. Thank you for staying focused. Thank you for sticking with me. You deserve every bit of it. Lisa Nicole Cloud, you're the best. You are. You're the best. The corporate staff at 5LINX. There's no way we could have done this without the corporate staff at 5LINX. Led by the five-star general, Eric Sheldon. Man, you're awesome, man. And where's Jamie? Hey, Craig, I don't know what you guys do to vote the top associate of the year, but let me tell you, man, she is something else. At the last convention, as I wrote at the last convention, I committed that I was going to go and take the organization platinum because it was very important that we do that. And we were working and struggling because, you see, we could have hit this position a while back, but we lost the whole entire organization leg internationally in Canada. And we had to turn around and rebuild another one and rebuild another one. And so I made a phone call to a young lady, and she decided to get on board. Her name is Rosa Battle. Where's Rosa Battle? She over there? And she's not the most coachable person in the world. But our organization wanted to make a transition, and it has not been easy for them. It's been a struggle for them. They thought they were going to bring thousands of representatives, and none of them came. And so we had to go out there and work hard, and she introduced me to some guys, Emmanuel Bernstein and ASI Unlimited and Kenneth Van out of Mississippi. I didn't even think they did network marketing in Mississippi. And we went to work. We went to work. And I left my little boy for many nights because I knew that we had to achieve this goal. And I spent countless hours on the road, countless hours. This last week, I think maybe I've slept maybe 5 hours because I was up all night long getting stuff into the system. But I want to tell you guys, thank you for joining us. Thank you for being a part of the organization. And I'm going to leave you guys with a story that I only read in special occasions like this. And I put it on paper before I was making any money in this business because I knew one day that I would. It is a story that's near and dear to my heart, and I hope it touched you as it touched my heart when I was putting it on paper. It's called Freedom. In the United States of America lies a large industrial city, site of one of the largest slave labor camps. Near the center are community settlements where the slaves live. Each morning they move herd life from their quarters into the industrial camp. Each one is his or her station by 7:30, where they're met by their master for the day's duties. Here they remain in chains until 5 p.m., then they are released. There's no choice in how many hours they must labor. Sometimes they're required to work overtime until their master tells them they may leave. Each year, they are told when to take their vacations and for how long. They are told when to return. They have very little choice in how much money they can earn, and they allow very little time for their lunch or coffee break during these labor hours. They remain in chains in great fear because their master can punish them with the whip. It's called the layoff whip. It says that some of these slaves are good and faithful to their masters, and they still feel the sting of that whip. Day by day and year by year, they toil until the master tells them they can stop. Then he releases them to the retirement camps where they're forced to sit idle and wait for death. It's a well-known fact that these old slaves have worked hard. And sometimes they're even whipped with the pension whip. I know these slave labor camps exist because I'm a free man who live among the slaves. I'm in a business for myself, and I'm truly free. I rise in the morning, call for my own schedule. I decide my own hours, and I can even sleep in late while the slaves are at work. I can vacation when and where, and for how long I please. I'm free to take my coffee breaks and lunch when I decide. And of course, I can decide my own paycheck because I am no longer a slave. I can work where and when with whom I please. I can live in the city or I can go out to greener pastures if I decide to. You know what? I've ever seen slaves pick up their belongings and move into a new city in search of a new master. There is a ray of hope for the slave, though. He or she may buy their own freedom. The price is not high for those who are willing to pay the price if they have the courage. What is the price? One must be willing to be their own master. One must be willing to be their own master. One must be willing to be their own master. God bless you. Thank you very much.
Congratulations again to new Platinum SVP, C. Anthony Harris and Barry Donalson.